Hello friends, how are you? This is Dr. Shinagi, Ayurveda and medicine doctor and also Isha Hatha Yoga teacher. So today in this video, I'm going to talk about what are the foods that are suitable for your brain, or you can also say it like superfood for brain. Many times these days, there is a lot of fashion for what is superfood for stomach, what is superfood for heart, what is superfood for strength. So today's video is about what is superfood for your brain, or in other words, there are certain kinds of foods which we eat that will nourish our brain. Specifically, the target organ for nourishment will be brain. So many of us must be thinking brain need nourishment. We always talk about nourishment of the body, nourishment of the body. And is there something that is called nourishment of the brain? Yes. There is something in Ayurveda that is called Medhya Rasayan that is very beneficial for the nourishment of your brain, because you would be surprised to know, most of our function, whether my movement of hand, whether my talking, whether my listening, like all these sensory functions, or taking food inside my mouth, moving my tongue inside my mouth, moving my lips, everything, like what I see, everything, all of what I see, all these functions are happening in brain. The center for all these functioning, like whatever happening in our body, like let's suppose I'm moving my hand like this, I'm assuming like, okay, I'm moving my hand like this. But actually, the center with which I am moving my hand, the center of this movement is in brain. So that's why brain becomes extremely important organ according to Ayurveda. That is called, that's why it is called Shirsha. Shirsha means it is superior to all the organs. But many times it happens like we confuse manas with brain. Manas is not brain. Mind is not brain. Brain, when I'm talking about, I'm talking about all the sensory functions, motor functions, that means movement of hand or sense of smell, sense of taste, sense of eyes, what I see. As you know, we have road cells, cone cells, and whatever is happening, whatever I'm seeing, it's everything is happening in brain. So brain is not something that is called manas. Manas is explained in Ayurveda, that is called mental body, and yoga, that is called mental body, like how we think, thoughts, everything, that is comprised of manas. But what we are like experiencing in the, like in terms of sense, vision, movement of hands, defecation, urination, peristaltic movements that are happening in our intestine, everything is controlled by brain. So it becomes this, so this our brain becomes extremely important organ, because brain is also organ just like your liver, just like your spleen, your kidneys. Similarly, brain is also an organ in your body, and that's why it's very important that we take care of this organ so that it will function well. As you know, like we have liver, and if there is some disturbance in liver, it produces certain symptoms. Like our LFT, that is liver functioning test, will be disturbed, or something, or some other thing will be disturbed if we have kidney problem, or like test clinically, it shows like what problem our brain is, our kidney or liver is going through. Similar is the thing with brain as an organ. If we don't pay attention for the health of our brain, then also it start functioning not in a best way. Like you will start feeling certain kind of weakness, your gait, the way you will walk, you feel very get tired very quickly, very easily. You will have a lot of stress, anxiety, all the time tension for small things, sometimes memory loss. You are not able to recall things, especially because of degeneration it happens. So brain is also doing a lot of things for us. It is just we are unaware of it, and that's why we don't pay attention what we need to do for the health of your brain. So, as it is very clear, like brain is extremely important organ of our body. So, it is very, very important that we take care of the health of brain. And let's see what Ayurveda has to say about it or how Ayurveda can help us regarding this. In Ayurveda, as you know, or even if you see in nature, it is very clearly been seen, if we nourish the roots of a plant, any root of a plant, then plant will blossom at its best. So, if we assume like humans are standing on their heads, so our heads, that is brain, is like a root, is like a root. It needs nourishment, like plant needs nourishment. And if we nourish our brain well, it all our functions, like whether it's walking, movement of hand, speaking skills, talking, listening, all these functions will get improved naturally if we pay attention to take care of the health of our brain. And for some reasons, if our brain get disturbed, then that will also produce symptoms in our body. As you know, in Charaka, like Maharshi Charaka, the father of Indian system of medicine or father of Ayurveda, he spoke very clearly. Whatever small thing is happening on in our body, it is going to impact our mind, because because our body is the larger version of our mind. So when I'm saying mind, I'm not saying brain. Similarly, whatever happening in mind, it is going to impact your body. That's why our brain health is also very much connected with our mind. For example, if our emotions are disturbed, that means according to Ayurveda, your sadhak pitta has been disturbed. That means the center of sadhak pitta in Ayurveda, or the place of sadhak pitta in Ayurveda, is heart. So it is very, very important that you do something that is very pleasant for your heart. Love. So love is the best therapy if your emotions have been disturbed. If somebody is disturbed emotionally and you are giving him a lot of rules, or you are dictating him like intellect, oh, you need to do this, you need to do that. Believe me, it will not work. It will not work because sadhak pitta is disturbed. If somebody's emotions are disturbed, this is the time that you show love. Because with love, with pleasantness, with emotions becomes balanced, your sadhak pitta will become balanced. And this is how that person will feel good. But if we keep scolding, why, what, then these things will not work. If emotions are evolved, please treat that person with love. That is the most important therapy which most of the people miss. At the same time, educate them, make them understand things also, but with love. If emotions are attached, you should always try to speak anything with love, with affections. That is the only thing that works when sadhak pitta is disturbed. And these emotions, if they get disturbed for a long time, it's going to impact your brain. You will see the degeneration in the brain happens very quickly in these kind of patients. If you go for the CT scan, for those people whose emotions are mostly disturbed, then you will see the CT scan, the degeneration changes will be very clearly visible. Or you can also understand it is like in modern terminology, there are hormones called like dopamine, serotonin. These are the very common terms these days coming into play when we talk about brain. Serotonin, that is also called happy hormone, and the secretion happens. It is very, very important for the health of your brain. And if your brain started going degeneration, I'm not talking about mind, not manas, I'm talking about brain. If your brain started going degeneration, then this dopamine content will also go down. And degeneration means less neurons, like with aging happens. Or these things happen most frequently to the people who are not into yoga, who are not into healthy lifestyle. After certain age, their degeneration of the brain happens. And when degeneration happens, in old age, many people, they are not able to stay happy. They become irritated, they become frustrated. This started happening because you are not taking care for the health of your brain. in addition to that, brain is also a part of your prana. According to Ayurveda, the vata that controls the brain, that is pranavayu, that is sabdosha of vata dosh. So that is responsible for the functioning of our brain. That's why we focus, that's why we recommend all the people to make their brain stronger. Please do pranayama or nadi shuddhi pranayama or pranayama, because more oxygen will go inside. That means more pranavayu will go inside. That is very, very beneficial to nourish your brain, to nourish your neurons. One of the simplest technique to do is just do Shambhavi Mahamudra. It is very, very beneficial technique to make your neurons work well. So this is ancient yogic techniques, and we can make use of it. Just give it a try, but make sure you learn from a proper source. Isha Shambhavi Mahamudra is also very beneficial, like, which include deep breathing, like breathing to inhalation and exhalation. So these things are extremely beneficial for the health of brain. I'm not talking about mind, that is manas. For mind, best work is meditation. It's very, very important that you acquire spiritual knowledge, you acquire awareness. These things work extremely well on manas, that is mind. It's a food for mind. And mind and brain are connected to some extent, so it's very, very important that we take care of the health of both aspects so that both will nourish each other. In addition to that, this brain is also a place of tarpak kapha. Tarpak kapha is sabdosh of kapha, which nourishes our meninges and brains and all the lubrication. And in Ayurveda, to enhance this tarpak kapha or to nourish your brain, the simple remedy is eat nuts. How to eat nuts? There, I have created a detailed video about how to eat nuts, how to soak them, how to remove the heat from them, and how they are kapha enhancing, and especially they are very beneficial for this tarpak kapha, which is extremely important for your brain. So all kind of nuts. It is not like if I speak about almonds and you say in your country there are no almonds, so our brain will not get enhanced. So it's not true. Whatever nut is there in your country, but make sure you should not be allergic to that nut. So you soak that nut, like 5 to 6 nuts, you just soak it, and just in the morning after fruits you can have these nuts. These nuts are extremely beneficial for the nourishment of your brain. It's called, it is almost equal to brain tonic. And if there is a possibility to have walnut, seasonal walnut every year, nature grows walnut and its shape is very much like brain. So all nuts comes in this category, but there is a way to eat nuts. So regarding that, there is a video, you check it out. In addition to that, what are the other things that will be beneficial to make your brain work well? That is, involve yourself in any work, whatever you like, in your hobby, like arts, where you can express yourself. So these things are very beneficial for the functioning of your brain. In addition to that, it's very important that you spend some time to do exercise or running or walking. All these things are also extremely beneficial to nourish your brain. In addition to that, you can include raisins in your diet, because raisins are very, very beneficial. It's a kind of brain tonic, and you can make use of it. And regarding raisins, there is a link in the description box below. You can click that link and you can make use of it. In addition to that, in Ayurveda, there is a wide variety of rasayanas that are medha rasayanas, like Brahmi. So you can have 2-3 leaves of Brahmi in the morning. It's very beneficial. It's extremely good medha rasayana, or the tonic for brain. And it is, the botanical name for this is Bacopa minori. So it's written below, you can read it. So you can read about more about this plant, and 2-3 leaves of this plant. It is also called Manduk Parni in Ayurveda. And you can use 3 leaves of it and as a salad. It is extremely nourishing brain tonic. It will improve your memory loss. It will enhance the functioning of your brain, general day-to-day activity. And if you're going through extreme stress and strain, this will also relax your mind. So these 3 leaves per day you can have, because excess of leaves can cause loose motions. So it's very, very important. Don't take more than 3 leaves. It's enough for a person. In addition to that, in Ayurveda, there is a concept of nasya that is also very good brain tonic, pratimarsh nasya, but that you can take only under the guidance of some Ayurveda doctor. In addition to that, there are various kind of rasayanas that are available in Ayurveda that are called Medhya rasayanas, but that is also you can take under the guidance of Ayurveda doctor, because various people have different kind of prakriti and a body constitution, so you cannot recommend single medicine to everyone, so you need Ayurveda consultation for that. In addition to that, you can have a milk of black cow, and that should be well nourished cow, well taken care of, because in Ayurveda it's been said if you taking milk from the black cow, it contains gold element in it, which is extremely beneficial for the nourishment of your brain. That's why in India, when child is small, they give cow milk to him, especially black cow, milk from black cow, not hybrid cow, like not the cow that has original genes, so that kind of cow that makes your brain extremely well. In addition to that, those people who are having proper nutrients for the body, ultimately your brain will also get nourished. At the same time, please have your dinners and have your food. Try to have it on time so that body will be well nourished, and if body will be well nourished, your brain will get automatically nourished. But these are certain things which you need to take care of, in which includes yoga, which is very beneficial for the health of your brain and the body and the nervous system. So try doing Upa Yoga. If you want to know more about Upa Yoga, there is a link in the description box below. You can click that link and you can know more about it, or you can write down to us. We will let you know how to do it. So that's all for today's video. I hope you will like this video and you will start taking care of your brain along with mind, along with body. So that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. And if you're watching me for the first time, there's a bell icon, there's a subscription button. You can click the bell icon, hit the subscription button so that you stay in tune with our upcoming videos. Also, if you would like to support us, there is a join button near subscription button. You can click this join button and you can support us. So with this note, I would like to say stay healthy, stay blessed, take care. And if you want to have Ayurveda consultation, please write down to us. If you want to ask certain question, please write down to us. We will try to answer your questions in the best possible way. So with this note, I would like to say stay healthy, stay blessed, take care. Bye. And don't forget to share my videos so that we can spread love and health to everyone. Bye.